10 Nelson, your community access television. Programming on this channel is made by local volunteers. If you would like to be a part of your community television, please call 354-4200 or write to Shaw Cable, 613 Ward Street, Nelson, B1L1T2.
I'd like to welcome Bev Dendys, Chairperson of School District Number 7.
Good evening. On behalf of the Board of School District Number 7, I would like to welcome you this evening and thank everyone for participating in Musicfest Nelson 91. Spectator, performer, or volunteer, you have all contributed to the tremendous success of Musicfest. I don't think you guys are waiting to hear the beginning of my speech. It's probably the end. In order that our students receive a well-rounded education. I have always been impressed by the students I've met and seen at occasions like this. Their dedication to their art is wonderful. Last night, during the concert performed by Eastern Washington University's Symphonic Band, there was a visible demonstration of that dedication. The audience was made up of at least 90% students, and their love and appreciation of that music was evident throughout the evening. The quality and variety of talents being showcased this weekend speaks well for the future of these students and emphasizes the important part music plays in the education system. I will close by again thanking all those involved in organizing Musicfest Nelson 91, and a special thank you to all the students who have provided us with such wonderful music. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, Bev. For 2 days, you have been performers and students. Tonight, you're to be entertained. Of your music, and to help the groups that are coming here to entertain us tonight to give their best, we must give our best and be an attentive audience. Number one, the Abbotsford Chamber Choir, directed by
Thank you. this is an audition group, but this is one of six chorals, choral groups at in the Abbotsford School, and we are. It's made up of students who are heavily involved in the instrumental side of the program as well. We are, again, like I said before, very fortunate to be here and fortunate to experience some very fine adjudication and by Mr. Trett and Dr. Tom Iverson. And we thank them very much for that and would ask that for the next piece, Crucifixus by Antonio Lotti, that Dr. Tom Iverson come up and conduct that, since we received such wonderful insight. Thank you. switch the tone a little bit and the atmosphere a little bit with these little Canadian content here called Canada in Springtime, written by Chris Dedrick.
I got the old man say,
just like to thank this festival and in particularly Kelly McCall for inviting us and putting on such a world of festival. It's already headed in the right direction in terms of the integrity of festivals and the non-competitive environment. I'm not sure that Antonio Lotti or Orazio Vecchi or any of these people really intended their music for competition, and it's really great to see that that component is downplayed in this festival, and I salute you for that. With a piece written by a Swedish, arranged by a Swedish composer, Valdemar Boyelin, and it's entitled The Earth to Dorn. Features a soprano solo by Chantal Sweet.
Another thank you. Chamber Choir. Quintessence is a brass quintet, and a particular interest to us at Nelson is that Gordon Wolfe, who directs this group, is a graduate of this very school. 2 years ago, went on to the University of Victoria with a regional district scholarship, and it's particularly pleasant to welcome him back with a group of his guys and gals. I don't know where they are. And here we are.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
evening, a local group called New Nation includes alto sax player Clint Swanson, who graduated from Mount Sentinel 2 years ago, spent a year in Selkirk College's professional music program, has been instrumental in organizing this group. I would like you to welcome New Nation.